In today's video, we're gonna look at how to write more appropriate tooltips when we are developing our forms. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jorson. Let's jump right in. It has come to my attention that writing tooltips is more of an art than I realized. So tooltips are what is displayed to a screen reader when people are accessing a form field using their assistive technology. If we were to launch JAWS right now, let's go ahead and launch JAWS, and I were to pull up my forms list, I could do that by pressing insert F5. There we go. So this pulls up like the list of all the form fields in this document. And this is a primary method that someone using JAWS would use to fill out this form. In addition to that, they may use the tab key, in which case this content will also be read aloud. So for last name, it should say last name edit. Let's go ahead and try that with our keyboard.
Last name colon edit type of text.
And so all of that tooltip information is vital for a screen reader user. So what we're gonna do to update these tooltips, we're going to open up the prepare a form option, and we're gonna right click the form field and select properties. Now, a lot of people have different opinions on what you should put in the tooltip. Some of the advice that I have gotten is to not include pleasantries. So instead of saying, please enter last name, the consensus is to just be clear and direct and just say what the field is. And in this example, it is last name. We'll select close, and we're just gonna validate some of these. So we have first name, address, that makes sense, city, state, and zip. This really should be three different fields. MCID, this is one that it looks like we can update. This one, I'm going to right click, select properties, and I'm going to say, enter Merced College ID number. And where I'm coming up with this is, I'm just using some logic. So MC probably stands for Merced College. ID is probably the student ID number. That's what that number represents. And we just want to be clear that we're entering as much information for the user, because MCID might not make sense, but enter Merced College ID number is a much stronger tooltip. Additionally, we could change the field type if we wanted to signature or some other content. Then we're gonna select close. We've got last four digits of SSN, DOB. I like to spell out the acronym, so I'm gonna right click, select properties, and I'm going to say, enter date of birth. And in this one, we could change the field type to date and select close. Now down here, we have a couple of spots that say disability and or medical condition, and there's actually two lines. So I want to delete one of those lines, and I'm actually going to expand the form field to include both of the lines, and then we're gonna adjust the properties. So let's right click the form field, select properties, and in here we have please include DSM-5 diagnosis if appropriate, and we're gonna remove that one information there, because now we removed number two, so it makes sense to just have this as with no number. I'll delete the one off the name, we'll select appearance. We can set the font size to auto. Position should be fine. Let's select options. We're gonna do left alignment, and we're going to allow multi-line and take off scroll long text. Scroll long text is an annoying feature that is not really accessible. Multi-line is much better. And because we set our font size to auto, it should shrink down based on the amount of data in there. So let's select close. And let's do this again. So functional limitations description 2, I'm gonna delete that number 2, expand the number 1 box, expand it, let's right click it and select properties. Now what I want to do, like how do I know what to write for the tooltip? Well, we need to look around. So this text box is clearly for this number 2 functional limitations, so we should be direct. So let's say enter any functional limitations, which might include degree of hearing level, limited ambulation, fatigue, etc. Well, we need to set our appearance to, or our options, I mean, to multi-line and select close. Now again, let's move on to prescribed medications and dosage. We can right click, select properties, general. So right now the tooltip is just 3. That's not very helpful. Let's say enter any medications and dosage and select close. So all I'm doing is I'm referencing where the box is. I'm trying to read using my eyes and come up with a relevant tooltip. Let's check the checkboxes. I'm going to right click, select properties. So the tooltip for this checkbox is permanent chronic. So that's some information. Technically that is the checkbox, but we want more information. So number 4 is saying, please check the term of the above mentioned disability as permanent, chronic, temporary. And so we need to enter more information into the tooltip. And we could say, is the above mentioned disability permanent, chronic? Select close. Actually, I'm going to right click it again, select properties, and I'm going to copy it so I don't have to type the whole thing. Let's check this next one, right click properties, and we're going to paste that into the tooltip. Is the above mentioned disability temporary, 45 days or greater? And we could take that, copy it, and then move into the next one, right click properties. And this one's temporary, less than 45 days, but we need that extra information, in my opinion. And then we delete out the extra text and select close. Do you recommend any special assistance? Let's right click it, select properties. Actually, let me close this. There's 2 lines here. So this is another candidate for multi-line. Let's right click it, select properties. Do you recommend any special assistance? That technically covers the label and all the information. We're just gonna wanna make this multi-line. Deselect scroll long text, select close. Now we're getting into a little bit more information here for the tooltips. So we have certified professional name and title. Remember at the top where we have last name and first name, it's important that we have something different for our certified professional. Let's right click it and select properties. General, this is perfect. Certified professional, it actually is asking for name and title. So I'm going to just retype this. Enter the certified professional's name and title. Select close. Let's check doctor's license number, right click. Perfect, doctor's license number. Let's check the signature properties. So instead of it just being signature, which I think it was originally, we have the tooltip of signature of certified professional. Because we also have this signature on the bottom, I'm gonna right click properties, where this just says signature. So this probably should be, to be honest, it's a little hard to tell what signature is supposed to be here. So I think it's supposed to be the student though. So I'm going to say student signature. And then again, up here for print name, let's right click it, select properties. What does print name even mean? Like that doesn't make any sense to me. I think we would need to get a little clarification to be honest with you, but let's just roll with student name, select close, and then title, select properties, and we would say like student title. And so again, we are referring to the information around the form field to develop these tooltips because it's going to make the screen reader user much happier to have all of this content in there in a meaningful way. That concludes today's video on how to write effective tooltips for forms within PDF using Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I can be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'll see you next time.